And right now, let's call this tech time. If the dog days of summer are keeping you indoors to escape the heat, well, we've got some very cool ideas to keep you very busy. Our tech guru, Mark Saltzman, joins us now from Toronto with some of the season's hottest, latest, coolest gadgets. So Mark, let's begin with Samsung's Galaxy Vibrant phone. This is very competitive with the iPhone. How similar or different are we talking?
Yeah, you're absolutely right. The 2010 summer was the summer of the smartphone, and there's no shortage of great picks. You mentioned the iPhone 4. There's the BlackBerry Torch, the 9800, and this guy here. This is probably the closest thing to an iPhone killer that I've seen. It is the Samsung Galaxy S Vibrant. It's a T-Mobile exclusive. It's an Android-powered phone, so it's got Google's operating system. So it's got, you know, those familiar applications you're used to, like Search and Gmail. It's got the ability to download 100,000 apps from the Android market, a gorgeous 4-inch touchscreen. Absolutely stunning. I hope your viewers get an idea of how stunning it is.
I get a good look at that, yeah. So why would I want that instead of the iPhone?
And finally, it's got something called DLNA. I can shoot a high-definition video on this, press a button, and it shows up immediately on a compatible television wirelessly. So really cool stuff, $200 with a two-year T-Mobile plan.
Wow, interesting. So that means that's going to kind of push the, you know, Apple or the creators of iPhone to take it to the next level in a very short turnaround, right?
That's right. They can't rest on their laurels, but Apple is enjoying a great success, of course, with the iPad as well. That's my second sort of hot gadget of the summer. The iPad, as most of your viewers know, it's an ebook reader, it's a gaming device, music, video, you name it. It's a great companion to travelers and even road trips by handing something like this to the kids in the back seat. So these start at $500. But for those who can't touch the screen very easily, maybe they've got long fingernails like my wife Kelly does, or if in the winter months if you use gloves, here's a cool solution for you that a lot of people don't know about. It's called the Pogo Sketch. It is the first stylus pen for the iPad. So instead of using your fingertips, you're actually using this little touch, stylus pen to draw and type on it. So for example, I just did this while I was waiting to do our interview. Look at that. Just drew that with the little stylus pen, and it's great for students also.
So Kelly with the long fingernails, does she like it?
She does. $15 for this, and it's available in 4 different colors.
Oh, wow. Okay, that's very good. All right, meantime, let's talk about Lady Gaga, and what in the world does she have to do with all this tech stuff?
Yeah, well, interestingly, musical artists are getting into the tech space more and more. You're probably familiar with the Diddy Beats headphones, Dr. Dre's line with Monster Cable, and now we've got Lady Gaga with her own line. So it's the idea is that you're fusing fashion with function. These are, if you can tell, they're sort of blinged out earbuds that I think a lot of women would prefer to wear over those little white earbuds that come with the iPhone or iPod. Yeah, the sound is great. They're very comfortable. They have these little gel tips, different sizes. You get a case with it. So it's not just for looks. It's not just for fashion. But again, it's sort of style meets substance.
Wow.
Much better sounding earbuds than what comes with your iPhone. They range from $89 to $129. They're not cheap. But certainly if you're an audiophile, you want to get more out of your smartphone or iPod, that would be a product for you.
Oh, cool. And you know what, Mark? Guess what? Last time you talked to us about a waterproof camera, you convinced me it was a waterproof video camera, and I went out and bought it. I test drove it on vacation. I loved it. And so now you've got yet another waterproof camera for us.
Yeah. The biggest thing to happen to cameras in 2010 is waterproof or adventure proof, as Sony calls it with this TX5. This is a $349 camera that can take a beating. You can drop it in winter months. It can freeze. But for the purposes of our chat for the summer, it is waterproof. So I'm dunking it in a glass full of water. It works no problems. It does shoot high-definition video as well. I think the last time we talked, Frederica, it was the Kodak PlaySport, which is a pocket cam that shoots video. This is a 10-megapixel still camera that also shoots photos. So you can see here, even despite it being wet, it works just fine. It's more for snorkeling than scuba diving. It's only good about 10 feet underwater.
Okay, same as that video camera. But that's fine by me, you know, because you know what? The scuba camera, it's a little bit too complicated for me because you got the casing. You got to get it in the water for so long, blah, 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 blah. You know, I'll let somebody else do that part. But this was great for just casual swimming and snorkeling. And so now looks like I'll have to try the still camera too. Per your recommendation. Okay, yeah, there's one more, right?
Yeah,
something about it. No need for a charger because? You've got this.
That's right. These are the first batteries that don't require, first rechargeable batteries that don't require a charger at all. They're called USB cell, and as the name suggests, you just pull off that hinged cap, and voila, it has a USB connector.
Oh my gosh.
So you simply plug these into a computer or the backseat of an airplane or a video game console, and it charges up these rechargeable batteries because underneath that hinged cap is a USB connector. So you do not need to plug a charger into the wall or carry one with you when you travel. So
wow.
Very clever idea, especially for parents who have kids that have a lot of battery-operated toys.
Yeah.
You know how many batteries you can go through. These are better for the environment because they're rechargeable.
Yeah.
And again, and now less stuff to carry with you because they charge up on a regular laptop or netbook or what have you.
Yeah, that was me on the plane with my little one when his DVD player stopped working because we needed more battery juice. And I was like, oh gosh, how are we going to get through this flight without it? I needed that. So I'm running out to the store yet one more time.
Y'all can relate.
All right, Mark Saltzman, thanks so much. Always good to see you. Appreciate it.
Likewise. Thanks.
Adios.